The first principle of success is desire, knowing what you want. Desire is the planting of your seed. Robert Collier. Visualize this thing you want. See it, feel it, believe in it. Make your mental blueprint and begin. Make every thought, every fact, that comes into your mind pay you a profit. Make it work and produce for you. Think of things not as they are but as they might be. Don't merely dream, but create. Any thought that is passed on to the subconscious often enough and convincingly enough is finally accepted. There is nothing on earth that you cannot have once you have mentally accepted the fact that you can have it. Be sure to visualize only what you want. The law works both ways. If you visualize your worries and your fears, you will make them real. Control your thoughts and you will control circumstances. Conditions will be what you make them. The great successful men of the world have used their imagination. They think ahead and create their mental picture in all its details, filling in here, adding a little there, altering this a bit and that a bit, but steadily building. You can do anything you wish to do, have anything you wish to have, be anything you wish to be. Faith is the confidence, the assurance, the enforcing truth, the knowing. Start where you are. Distant fields always look greener, but opportunity lies right where you are. Take advantage of every opportunity of service. All of us have bad luck and good luck. The man who persists through bad luck, who keeps right on going, is the man who is there when the good luck comes, and is ready to receive it. Thought is energy. Mental images are concentrated energy. And energy concentrated on any definite purpose becomes power. You cannot hold on to anything good. You must be continually giving and getting. You cannot hold on to your seed. You must sow it and reap anew. You cannot hold on to riches. You must use them and get other riches in return. Take the first step, and your mind will mobilize all its forces to your aid. But the first essential is that you begin. Once the battle is started, all that is within and without you will come to your assistance. Our subconscious minds have no sense of humor, play no jokes, and cannot tell the difference between reality and an imagined thought or image. What we continually think about eventually will manifest in our lives. People blame their environment, their education, their opportunities, their luck, for their condition. They are wrong. There is one person to blame, and only one, themselves. One might as well try to ride two horses moving in different directions, as to try to maintain an equal force two opposing or contradictory sets of desires. Playing safe is probably the most unsafe thing in the world. You cannot stand still. You must go forward. See things that you want as already yours. Know that they will come to you at need. Then let them come. Don't fret and worry about them. Don't think about your lack of them. Think of them as yours, as belonging to you, as already in your possession. Plant the seed of desire in your mind and it forms a nucleus with power to attract to itself everything needed for its fulfillment. We can do only what we think we can do. We can be only what we think we can be. We can have only what we think we can have. What we do, what we are, what we have, all depend upon what we think. If you see yourself as prosperous, you will be. If you see yourself as continually hard up, that is exactly what you will be. The greater the prevalence of positive thoughts, the more likely you are to receive a positive outcome. The great thing is the start, to see an opportunity for service, and to start doing it, even though in the beginning you served but a single customer, and him for nothing. You can do anything you think you can. This knowledge is literally the gift of the gods, for through it you can solve every human problem. It should make of you an incurable optimist. It is the open door. Vision, it reaches beyond the thing that is, into the conception of what can be. Imagination gives you the picture. Vision gives you the impulse to make the picture your own. It is only through your conscious mind that you can reach the subconscious. Your conscious mind is the porter at the door, the watchman at the gate. It is to the conscious mind that the subconscious looks for all its impressions. If you have any lack, if you are prey to poverty or disease, it is because you do not believe or do not understand the power that is yours. It is not a question of the universal giving to you. It offers everything to everyone, there is no partiality. The source and center of all man's creative power is his power of making images, or the power of imagination. It is your work to clear away the mass of encumbering material of thoughts, so that you may bring into plain view the precious thing at the center of the mass. If you procrastinate when faced with a big difficult problem, break the problem into parts, and handle one part at a time. Face towards the perfect image of every organ and the shadows of disease will never touch you. Knowing that you are working with a force, which never yet has failed in anything it has undertaken, you can go ahead in the confident knowledge that it will not fail in your case either. Whatever it is necessary for you to know, whatever it is necessary for you to do, you can know and do if you will but seek the help of this genie of your mind and work with it in the right way. Prayer is not a mere asking for favors. Prayer is not a paean of praise. Rather, prayer is a realization of the God power within you, of your right of dominion over your own body, your environment, your business, your health, your prosperity. Man's principal business in life, as I see, is to establish a contact with universal mind. It is to acquire an understanding of this power that is in him. Drive yourself. Force yourself. It is the dreamer, the man with imagination, who has made the world move. Without him, we should still be in the Stone Age. Most of us, swimming against the tides of trouble the world knows nothing about, need only a bit of praise or encouragement, and we will make the goal. No one ever knows how small is the margin between failure and success. Frequently the two are separated by the width of that one word, discouragement.